So many possessions that they could not stay together, and Jacob's livestock and the herdsman's livestock. At that time, the Canaanites and the Perizzites were living in the land. Then Abram said to Lot, "Please, let's not have quarreling between you and me, or between your herdsmen and my herdsmen, since we are relatives. Isn't the whole land before you? Separate from me. If you go to the left, I will go to the right. If you go to the right, I'll go to the left." Lot looked out and saw that the entire Jordan Valley, as far as Zoar, was well watered, everything like the Lord's garden in the land of Egypt. This was before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. So Lot chose the entire Jordan Valley for himself. Then Lot journeyed eastward, and they separated from each other. Abram lived in the land of Canaan, but Lot lived in the cities of the valley and set up his tent near Sodom. Now the men of Sodom were evil, sinning greatly against the Lord. After Lot had separated from him, the Lord said to Abram, "Look from the place where you are. Look north and south, east and west. For I will give you and your offspring forever all the land that you see. I will make your offspring like the dust of the earth, so that if anyone could count the dust of the earth, then your offspring could be counted. Get up and walk around the land through its length and width, for I will give it to you." So Abram moved his tent and went to live near the oaks of Mamre at Hebron, where he built an altar to the Lord. Abram rescues Lot. In those days, Amraphel, king of Shinar, Ariach, king of Elasar, Shadar, Lower Mayor, king of Elam, and Tidal, king of Goam, waged war against Bera, king of Sodom, Persia, king of Gomorrah, Shinab, king of Adam, and Shemeber, king of Zeboam, as well as the king that is Zor. All of these came as allies to the valley of Sodom. Sidom, that is the Dead Sea. They were subject to Chedorlaomer for 12 years, but in the 13th year they rebelled. In the 14th year, Chedorlaomer and the kings who were with him came and defeated the Rephaim in Asheroth, Arnaim, the Zizim, and Ham, the Emim, and Sheveh, Kiriathim, and the Arias in the mountains of Seir, as far as El Paran by the wilderness. Then they came back to invade in Mishpat, that is Kadesh, and they defeated all the territory of Amalekites, as well as the Amorites who lived in Hazazon Tamar. Then the king of Sodom, the king of Gomorrah, the king of Admah, the king of Zeboam, and the king of Bela, that is Zoar, went out and lined up for battle in the valleys of Sodom against Chedorlaomer, king of Elam, Tidal, king of Goam, Amraphel, king of Shinar, and Ariach, king of Elasar, 4 kings against 5. Now the valley of Sodom contained many asphalt pits, and as the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah fled, some fell into them, but the rest fled to the mountains. The 4 kings took all the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah and all their food and went on. They also took Abram's nephew Lot and his possessions, for he was living in Sodom, and they went on. One of the survivors came and told Abram, the Hebrew who lived near the oaks belonging to Mamre, the Amorite, the brother of Eshcol and the brother of Aner. They were bound by a treaty with Abram. When Abram heard that his relative had been taken prisoner, he assembled his 318 trained men born in his household, and they went in pursuit as far as Dan, and he and his servants deployed against them by night, attacked them and pursued them as far as Zoba, to the north of eunuchs who were with him. The king of Saddam went out to meet him in the valley of Shaveh, that is the king's valley. Then Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out bread and wine. He was a priest to God Most High. He blessed him and said, Abram is blessed by God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, and I give praise to God Most High, who has handed over your enemies to you. And Abram gave him a tenth of everything. Then the king of Saddam said to Abram, give me the people, but take the possessions for yourself. But Abram said to the king of Saddam, I have raised my hand in an oath to Yahweh, God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, that I will not take a thread of sandal strap or anything that belongs to you, so you can never say, I made Abram rich. I will take nothing except what the servants have eaten. But as for the share of the men who came with me, Aner, Eshcol, and Mamre, they can take their share. Abrahamic covenant. After these events, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. Do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield. Your reward will be very great. But Abram said, Lord God, what can you give me since I am childless and the heir of my house is Eliezer of Damascus? Abram continued, look, you have given me no offspring. So a slave born in my house will be my heir. Now the word of the Lord came to him. This one will not be your heir. Instead, one who comes from your own body will be your heir. He took him outside and said, look at the sky and count the stars if you are able to count them. Then he said to him, your offsprings will be that numerous. Abram believed the Lord, and he credited it to him as righteousness. He also said to him, I am Yahweh, who brought you from Ur for the Chaldeans to give you this land to possess. But he said, Lord God, how can I know that I will possess it? He said to him, bring me a 3-year-old cow, a 3-year-old female goat, a 3-year-old ram, a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. So he brought all these to him, split them down the middle, and laid the pieces opposite each other. But he did not cut up the birds. Birds of prey came down on the carcasses. But Abram drove them away as the sun was setting. A deep sleep fell on Abram, and suddenly great terror and darkness descended on him. Then the Lord said to Abram, know this, for certain your offsprings will be foreigners in a land that does not belong to them. They will be enslaved and oppressed 400 years. However, I will judge the nation they serve, and afterward they will go out with many possessions. But you will go to your fathers in peace and be buried at a ripe old age. In the fourth generation they will return here, but the iniquity of the Amorites has not yet reached its full measure. When the sun had set and it was dark, a smoking fire pot and a flaming torch appeared and passed between the divided animals. On that day the Lord made a covenant with Abram, saying, I give this land to your offsprings from the brook of Egypt to the Euphrates River, the land of Kenites, Kenizzites, Kadmonites, Hittites, Perizzites, Rephaim, Amorites, Canaanites, Girgashites, and Jebusites. Psalms 148. Master. obsess in all judges of the earth, young men as well as young women, old and young together. Let them praise the name of Yahweh, for his name alone is exalted. His majesty covers heaven and earth. He has raised up a horn for his people, resulting in praise to all his godly ones, to the Israelites, the people close to him. Hallelujah. Trembling fell down before him and died. is dead. Why bother the teacher anymore? But when Jesus overheard what was said, he told the synagogue leader, "Don't be afraid, only believe." He did not let anyone accompany him except Peter, James, and John, James' brother. They came to the leader's house and he saw a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. He went in and said to them, "Why are you making a commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." They started laughing at him. But he put them all outside. He took the child's father, mother, and those who were with him, and entered the place where the child was. Then he took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talitha kum," which is translated, "Little girl, I say to you, get up." Immediately the girl got up and began to walk. She was 12 years old. At this, they were utterly astounded. Then he gave them strict orders that no one should know about this and said that she should be given something to eat. And this, my friends,